Hey everyone, welcome to Kip TV. I am Kip, and today I've got a sixes match for you. Wink, wink, and nudge, nudge on Coal Plant. It is between two teams that took place in the Brazilian Federation, Team Fortress 2 Brazilian Federation, I think is the name of the cup that happened a couple of months ago there in the division, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. I'm not even going to try. Something with tacos, but it's not really tacos. Anyway, the teams are Mess Up versus Vintage. Mess Up in blue. Let's meet the teams. We have Kashyyyk as Soldier. Pony KG as Medic. Yoshi is going to be Soldier. Eratus is Demoman. And then Aratinga and Power are Scouts. Over on red, we have WN as Demoman. Mortz and Scatman are going to be Soldiers. Rebrick is Scout. Saw is Medic. And Leon is on Pyro. So that's going to be interesting. We are on Coal Plant, so let's get to the action. We're gonna watch. We'll just finish watching the Scatman roll. He's got a nice little fast jump. Has to pause or reload, but getting some of that sweet heals. And already we have the battle royale for the roof of Shed right here. Important to control that upper ground. It looks like so far red is getting the best of it. Blue Med is caught out a little bit, barely gets back in time. Ipony taking some damage right there, but already two down for the Mess Up team. So Vintage doing a good job pushing them back, but Pony did survive. So these Ubers are even, and we'll be seeing them deployed relatively soon. I think they're even. Yeah, that's Ubers. Red being super aggressive right here. Definitely want to get that med pick because they don't want Uber versus Uber. They want Uber versus nothing. We'll see if they decide to pop offensively and, you know, pop and push in. It's probably a risky play right here and probably not completely necessary. They have stickies, and here comes the blue team. Blue Demoman trying to get in there, but not able to do so. His medic lost him for a bit as the Uber is popped, and here comes the red Uber. They're actually just gonna fall back. There's no reason they want to overcommit. Yeah. No reason to get back in there. So blue did take back the loft area, also known as lobby, also known as concrete, also known as warehouse. I don't know what you guys call it. I call it lobby, I guess. I don't know. It's kind of a big lobby. Maybe, I don't know. Warehouse works, because that's what it looks like. Anyway, that was a fake call for sure. Both medics know that, because they're about even in these Ubers. Red, though, having good control of the point, and bomb in here for more. It's trying to get a scout or somebody, but they scattered like a flies. Leon, it should be noted, did go to scout, so he's not going to be on Pyro, which is sad, because I do like Pyro in sixes, especially when it's run normally. Shout out to Hobbs, who is an excellent sixes pyro. Anyway, we do have 90% Ubers here for these teams. We're going to see a push out from blue soon, but red, of course, obviously ready for it. We'll get an Eratus's cam. He was Eratus's cam. Looks like, I'm not sure what the wind conditions are for this map, but Eratus does go down. His medic drops him, and it's going to be Uber Soldier to try to get out here for Team Mess Up, but Mess Up not going to be able to do it. And that was some explosions right there for the med. Despite that, though, Red does lose two players, but only three up right now for Mess Up. Let's get on the Mess Up cam. We haven't seen too much of their action, I realize, because we've been so focused on the good job that Vintage is doing right now. Only 52 seconds left on the clock. And Mess Up Scouts are just kind of running back and forth, not sure what to do, because their entire blue team entire red team is out there waiting for some of these overheals as well. Aratanga is going to push in here, trying to get something going here. Has those uber overheals that are working to his advantage, and just putting down some scatter gun damage. Now he's going to have to go hunting for this scout who got away. Oh man, and there finally Leon does go down to a pill though. Aratanga is going to take advantage of the fact that the point is pretty much abandoned right now, and he and a soldier are going to get some time right there. And without 14 seconds left, they really have no other choice. And a huge bomb though by the soldier, and that scam man, he does get Ipony, but he goes down immediately after. The point was stopped, or the capture was stopped right there, so the point is still in red's favor. Oh, huge blaze coming in from Kiyoshi, and with his scout to get that combo. Nice, nice action right there. Will it be enough though? They still don't have this point. Oh my god, Eratus with 4 health. And he's going to drink his sign. That's how happy he is. So nice cap right there. But that's the least of their problems. The big problem is they have to hold this point for 3 minutes, which is so long in TF2 time. But yeah, like I was saying, I'm not sure about the win conditions. I'm thinking we're going to go to three round wins, or maybe, yeah, like a half, because they are playing best of three maps. This was the first of the map. It was chosen by Team Vintage, so supposedly they're pretty good on this map, and that's pretty much what we've seen, but they have yet to win this first round, so don't count your chickens, as they are building, and we'll have this Uber soon, but iPony is waiting with his Uber. So, anyway, I'm only able to cast one of these games. I apologize for that, but I'm super, super backloaded. But I will tell you what happened in the other two maps after this game is over. But definitely a long night of TF2 ahead of them, which is always so much fun with the grand finals. You'd rather have grand finals be long, because that way you know it wasn't a fluke if you won. Because if you had a really short, like, half-hour grand finals match, you're like, well, how do I really know we showed our best, and how do I really know that they were trying, and I don't know. Anyway, we have these Ubers even. Both soldiers from both teams are patrolling a little bit. Kachik is going to fall back here as red Uber is pop, pushing onto the point. Huge bomb in from the double man. That Uber is pop. Kachik goes down as he was not going to get any of that Uber. We do have heavy versus heavy, so interesting that both teams decided to off-class to heavy right here. Blue doing a good job defending, and only three up right now for the red team. One of those is the double man, but he goes down on the point. Soldier goes down, and that's a wipe. Vintage completely wiped right there. Get out the sham, wow, because that is a wipe. Crazy. So really nice defense out of this mess up team. Only 60 seconds left. I did not think they were going to be able to do it, considering they went down to the last few seconds in overtime to capture this point. But they're holding steady. That heavy move was definitely a good choice. But they've got to watch out, because now we do have the counter to a heavy, of course, is a sniper. So Leon on that sniper, trying to figure out where that heavy is, because he definitely thwarted Vintage's plans last time. And we already have some time getting in on the point. It is Vintage pushing in, but that blue Uber is popped on the heavy. Oh, Saw is 98% Uber. And does get the rest of that. Will pop on Demo Man. So that's not fortunate that he ran into the demo and lobby right there. But can't connect with this heavy. What? 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 That was ridiculous heavy dodging. And more great defense out of this mess up team. They're going to be able to hold it. They're going to hold it for 3 solid minutes. Mort's trying his damnedest. And not, wow, that is crazy. So mess up taking the first win. Wow, wow. And that's why you never call games early, because you will definitely eat your words or your hat or whatever you're hungry for. Watch Aradus in his rollout, getting out there just milliseconds earlier than his opposing demo man, and able to put down some sticks. And as you can see, WN had to fall back because of those milliseconds that matter. So crazy with these rollouts, and Aradus getting those overheals too, which definitely make a difference. Have some scout bouncing action on the roofs. But it looks like, I'm not sure why mess up is, okay, they're just rotating right, it looks like. So they're falling back, letting them take the point, even though they could contest right here because they have the same numbers. But they were not healing, so they're actually at an uber disadvantage unless red is running that Kritzkrieg, which would be sneaky, sneaky. And it is indeed regular Uber, which is popped immediately. A nice bomb in there from Kiyoshi forces that Uber pop. So iPony is going to have this Uber ready to counter if needed, but they really don't need it to capture the point. And that is good news. So well played from Mess Up. Just very patient and waiting. And now they have this Uber and are in control of the point. So, yeah, nice. Exactly the position they want to be in. And red team, and not too happy about that. Vintage coming out strong, but really weren't able to sustain that hold. I want to watch, see what WN does right here. I probably should have had some sticks on the roof, because you know the soldiers are going to be jumping there, and that's a sticky's obviously a huge counter to that. Do that threat. Rebrick taking out power after power was able to get in on. Who did power get? Power got somebody, but the kill feed went too fast. Anyway. He is down, but now he's back up. The person that power got. Anyway, We still have this Uber waiting to be popped from Blue. They haven't... They really, really shouldn't have this. Apparently, Blue lost their Uber advantage by 39 seconds. The STV stats. I've never seen that before. That's kind of awesome. Yeah, I knew that Blue lost their Uber advantage, but you know, STV stats, when you're in control of the point, it's not like you're going to pop and be offensive, unless you really... unless you're defending for a long amount of time, but really, Mess Up is in an okay position right here. Guy was distracted. I was going to say something much more interesting, but STV stats distracted me. So we'll see. As Red decides to push in here, they don't pop quite yet. Here comes Blue Team and the Blue Uber with that heavy again. Oh, Scatman didn't get a flash right there. He goes down pretty easily, so now it is just the Soldier and Medic on the point. Actually, Scout doing a good amount of work dancing around and confusing Power the Heavy. So nicely done right there, and let's not forget the Spy plays. Who is that on Spy? And that is Leon, who has decided to go Spy. So interesting. We'll see if Mess Up has a counter this, but it looks like we do have a pause. Right back. We're back with the action. It looks like we did have a player drop, and now Mush is going to be in here. And love that name, Mush, with a capital H, just in case. A rat is bombing in here. Did not see that Scatman was on his tail. We do have 57% Uber ready and well, not ready to do anything. Not that we're going to do anything with that. Esau is falling back. Now, Power is on Spy, so there's a Spy somewhere. Where is he? Is the question. But Saw's gonna have this Uber real soon. But Pony is building close to it. In comes a big bomb by the Demo Man. He's gonna be able to down goes Saw. Wow. Red's med died with 97% Uber, says STV stats. Thank you, STV stats. So 97. That sucks. I thought for sure Power was gonna get some action in there. But he is just kind of patrolling around trying to do something. We'll see now with this 100% Uber advantage what Mess Up decides to do. And they're going to go for the point. That's much is for sure. We'll see, though. As, yeah. Uber is popped in here. Red scatters. STV stat says Red spent 13.8 seconds after spawning before healing. That is really interesting. I'm getting distracted again as Pony goes down. Rebrick got in and on his face. And that really shouldn't happen because he was surrounded by his players. But no protection right there for the med. So down goes Pony. Saw, meanwhile, have this 60% Uber advantage. She's building fast. And there we go. That is a crit. I thought maybe as much. And suspicions confirmed if he can survive. But Power was going to do everything in his power to make sure he didn't survive. However, Saw still up. And we'll see this crit soon. Yeah, I'm not sure if I like those STV stats. They're kind of distracting, but interesting nonetheless. We'll see. As soon as they spot that enemy medic, they're going to pop, or if the Devilman is jumping in there. So far, this crit's not doing anything. One long-range crit gets it. WN right outside spawn takes out Arantiga and iPony. What a crit. Charged Sticky right there, so perfectly placed. Good anticipation, buys his team some more time on the point, and it's gonna get close right here. 37 seconds left for Vintage on the clock. Remember, only 30 seconds left for the Blue Team. That is Team Mess Up. And right now, Red just looking pretty aggressive. Well, yeah, not too aggressive. They are falling back here, which is the right call. They have this crits, need to keep the meta alive and get that crits up. So as soon as Blue comes in with this last minute push, they can stack the point with crits, which is, I think, what we'll be seeing here soon. Crits is popped on the Soldier Heavy going down. Power took two of those rockets in the face. And oh no! Saw jumped down when he should have stayed up and retreated to stay alive, because definitely Blue is going to be able to take this. They had just better positioning. Scout going to get in here. What? Where was Scatman that he was able to come in? Oh, but he lands on a pill! Oh, he stepped on a pill. If only it had looked behind him. Look where you're walking, man. So he does go down. It means we're going to go into overtime as the seconds tick away for Mess Up on the clock. That crits really could have been better and cleared off the point, but it just wasn't meant to be. And after iPony went down, there goes the heals. heels. They didn't have heels advantage, but there goes the heels. They needed to stack the point. Oh, and some nice rackets out of Scatman to take down Kachek. Down goes Medic as well. Aratus, the only one left alive, but he's not going to be able to do anything. And that round will go to Team Vintage. So some nice plays and stuff we're seeing out here. So I was going to stick on the regular Uber. I mean, the crits. Just look at crits and just completely call it the wrong thing. Looks like iPony is charging fast too. He may be on the crits as well. But we did see out of the corner by Kachek getting a nice bomb in onto the roof. Saws caught out. Will he be able to escape? He does get away with his double man, but guess he's waiting at the top of the stairs. It's more blue soldier action. No, Saw will get away alive. Mush trying his best. Oh my goodness, that's sticky. I guess is a word for it. But yeah, iPony is on this crit. We do have the crits coming in from me. Oh my goodness. Huge long range crits and takes out Pony right there. Blue's medic died with 100% Uber. Well, that was crits, of course. But wow, some big plays out of W. And he knows how to charge those stickies just enough. Doesn't waste too much time, but definitely gets the placement on them. And that has been huge these last couple plays for Team Vintage. So Blue is going to have to scatter to kind of regroup from that. It looks like Power has gone Sniper as one of their methods of coping, if you will. We'll see how that goes. We'll come back to him in a minute as he tries to get some good positioning. Meanwhile, Red is just trying to take back their... trying to push into the warehouse as Blue is trying to take it back. We do have crits popped. We'll see if Moritz can get anything. He does get Kachek, takes down Power. He spotted the combo, but down goes his medic. Some nice stickies out of Aratus. Takes out that threat, but look who's still on the medic. Oh, Scatman, so close, but it doesn't matter because there's Moritz to clean up. Moritz still alive. I thought for sure he had gone down. He brings out that escape plan equalizer. I don't know which one he was doing, and does not leave the warehouse, but definitely gets the job done. So crazy action right here. It looks like Aratinka is going to try to push in here, but he's way too hurt. Not going to be able to get too much time on the point. Instead, Aratus, with a little bit more health, is going to try to get in there, as he is joined by the rest of his team. They don't have too many heals right now. iPony just getting back up into the part where his heavier classes are. Those scouts getting most of those early heals, and oh man, Rebrick getting iPony just again able to get in there, and iPony just hasn't been having great defense around him. Just kind of been scattered, especially in the position when they're falling back into like right here. Of course, on their side, it would be right here, and iPony has died several times in this position, so definitely gotta watch out for that. Of course, very easily said, very much harder to do. Hardly to do. We'll get in the WN cam because he wants some of this crits. Oh, it's actually going to be the soldier who gets the first couple of rockets. Oh, WN trying to protect his medic right here. And finally, Mush does go down, but a good job for Mush to kind of distract right there. Oh no, WN, a little bit AFK. That's no good. That is no good. This is the, what is it called? The Team Fortress Brazil Federation Tournament. Or it was a cup, or something like that. Serious business here. Serious. I don't know what they got. I wonder what they got. The pride and joy of being Brazil's finest, I'm guessing? Anyway, only 56 seconds left for Vintage, as they're just kind of dancing around the point. Saw has that 100% crits ready to go, but guess what? So does Pony, and a big bomb here! Oh, man! Oh, wow. Mush gets Saw. So huge swing right there. We'll see. Red is now just trying to force this crits out of Blue in a position where they can't really do too much with it, but they stayed alive. In comes a red soldier, though. Oh my goodness, it's regular Uber. So Uber is forced. Not a terrible force right there. Aratus is going to be able to take some of it and get this demo pick, and WN does go down right there, so that threat out of the way, but in comes a big jumping soldier that is going to take down Mush, but oh god, the chaos. Where is iPony is the question. He was trying to get under, but the scout will not die. He's got some crazy legs as Leon finally goes down. Meanwhile, scouts for Blue able to take the point and hold off. Well, 2 seconds left on the clock. Jesus. Water break. Woo! That is crazy. Coal plant. A lot of fun. A lot of fun. We'll see. Okay, so they know that Pony is on this regular metagun. What is Saw on? Saw is on that crits again. So gonna get back onto the WN cam as he should be getting this fast because they've got to know that their advantage is slowly fading. They have this beautiful crits advantage, but it is gone by now. And they just have to make sure to get this medic before medic pops Uber and long range sticky. Oh, nope, not going to do it. That sticky alerted iPony to the fact that that crits was popped. He was able to get that Uber off just in time. Here comes blue defense, but oh, it does a great job of drawing out that Pony and Kachek, and then so a nice jump in there from opposing soldiers. I think Moritz was there, got that med pick. So Red gonna have to take advantage of that as blue not really have any presence here at mid. They're coming back right here, and again power on that super powerful heavy weapons guy. But where is Red moving in on that? I guess they lost Moritz, so they didn't feel like maybe, yeah. Well, anyway, we do have the heavy ready. Scatman jumping in there, trying to get iPony, but iPony staying alive and a good low-key positioning. He's back on that regular crits. Jumps down, which is a bad idea to take on the scout by himself. The needles are flying, but Pony will get away alive. Meanwhile, Red is taking back this point. Where is Blue to stop it is the question. Saw is now on regular Uber. Not even going to matter as time ticks down and Vintage will take the round, and the match goes 2-1 in favor of Vintage. The way Churros TV, except that's probably Churros with the rolling of the R's. I can't do that, so I won't. Anyway, little battle of the Dumbmen again. WN, I'm sorry, WN taking down Arantiga as he had some stickies on the roof, it looks like. But will back up as he doesn't have heals. Meanwhile, only half of the blue team is alive. It looks like there may be something wrong with the soldier. Scatman took too much damage right there, I would think, to be comfortable with. But he is back, and with his med... I think that was Scatman. Scatman? No, okay, that was Moritz. Moritz is wearing the ears, horns, things. Whatever. We do have regular crits ready to go for each. Pony is just going to pop it immediately and some nice midair crits jumping. He's going to get out of there though. Kachek is so excited to get in there, but then that Uber popped. Nope. Not going to happen. Now we do have Dumbman in here in the warehouse. Oh, and he's going to finish off himself. WN trying to make something happen right there. Really wanted that med pick, but Pony was able to get away safe distance. We'll see if... Blue is able to capture this. Really not a whole lot of red presence, so they probably will be able to. Although Blue needed some heals. Power's still on heavy, so... And Rebrick has gone heavy as well. Scatman coming in for the med pick. He's gonna get that easily. Oh, man. I wonder where Power was. Okay, so Power's on the opposite side. Or just not with his med. That's interesting. Because they are obviously using the heavy right now as a defensive position, but I feel like with all the jumping medics, soldier jumping onto medics that we've seen, the heavy would be a really good defensive medic. Defense for the med, as in just stick with the med, and just spawn that anti-aircraft gun, as what High GPS calls it. Really a good jumping deterrent, kind of like we're going to see right here with Rebrick. He is able to gun down Kachek in mid-air. Keeping his med Saw alive for a little bit longer. Where's Saw going? Okay, he's going into a corner. Thought he was charging in. I was like, sir, no. Sir, that is a bad idea. He does have this 100% Uber ready to go. We'll see if they decide to pop it. Looks like Yoshi may be back and may be ready to get back into playtime. I don't like this. Everybody is under there. They're obviously hiding, have some sort of elite strategy going on here. But now the... Oh! The air shot, Scatman taking down Power in mid-air. Was that Power or was that Kachek? I don't know what happened, but regardless, it was pretty sweet explosion in mid-air. But you can't leave your med alone, even no matter how sweet your explosion is. But it looks like Saw able to stay alive. Although they're all still pushing in here. That's some really aggressive plays. They did quite a bit of damage on Pony, so trying to force that. But with their med so far forward, this is not a good plan. And look at this positioning. Oh, Saw somehow getting away alive. Wow. Did not think he'd make it away alive. iPony also gets away alive. And with this player advantage, they will push onto the middle point, also known as midpoint. If you have, if you're so busy, you can't pronounce the second syllable in middle. Midpoint. Anyway. Of course, TF2 people are busy. We got stuff to... crates to unbox and hats to wear. Super, super busy. Can't be bothered saying middle and whatnot. So, alright, we still have both heavies in the game. And it just, it's not too much of a disadvantage. The thing is, King of the Hill, sometimes you won't see heavies run at all because it takes them so long to get out to mid. We do have this Uber Pop, so I'll continue that thought later, but some nice protection right there. Power takes down WN. We'll see if he can take down this Moritz too, and he does. So Pony will have this 100% crits. One more threat left, and Leon gets taken out. Saw is the only one left alive right now. Pony has this 100% Uber. So that's what I was talking about earlier, this just combo that like you see in Highlander, where the heavy just is absolute last bodyguard for the med and never leaves the med alone. And you can see that Power did a good job right there protecting his med. So we'll see. We have Leon has gone to spy. So that's fun. He knows exactly where that combo is holding because everybody in his team just tried to take them down. He also knows that they probably have this Uber by now, so he's gonna get in here. Gonna get the heavy! Oh, several pokes, but not enough. They did force the Uber, so that's nice. Conscious objector kill, what? Okay. So the Uber is popped, and Saw's gonna have his Uber real soon because they've been building in spawn. So now Blue is on their toes. Mess Up is not happy about that. They really didn't want to force that pop, but that spy just got in and up on their business. Dang, Leon, who's back on scout, by the way. So iPony trying to stay alive, get all of his players overhealed because they know this pop is coming soon. And where is it is the question. Saw finally does pop right there. A ton of assaults going down on this side. In comes WN and does take down Pony with some stickies. He was midair. A nice shot for Moritz. Finish off. Good check. They do have time on the point, but they need to get on the point. Moritz goes down. Leon is finished off as well. It's just the heavy and scout. And guess who wins? It's the scout. What? We're going to go 2-2. Mess Up with a nice, nice win right there. I'm sorry, I keep calling WN. I keep calling him VW because there's V's in his name and I know he's just a bunch of letters. So I apologize about that, WN. I hope WN is your name. I don't know how it's pronounced in Brazil. Maybe something different. I actually don't even know that these are completely Brazilian teams. They could be just a tournament. Oh, barely missing with that air pipe. Does connect right there to take down Mush, who's been an exciting... incoming person to the match. I don't know what I'm trying to say there. Oh, some nice stickies will take out Pony, just anticipating perfectly where he was going. We'll see Airpipe. I try again. No, but that heavy is not long for this world. So interesting, the power is on heavy, running heavy to mid. And that's what I was going to get to earlier, is you generally don't see Six's teams running heavy initially. Oh, Scat Man. Oh, Scat Man with a nice shot. I think that was a air shot. But yeah, so heavy is so slow that you usually don't have them running it to mid all the time. And of course, it's not like you're gonna have teleporters because NGs in sixes are not the norm unless you're 5CP last. So heavies, their slowness is definitely going to be an issue. But here on Coal Plant, it's a lot shorter. Not a lot shorter, but it's the distance is not as much, and your heavy, it can be protected depending on his rollout, especially in the warehouse. There's places he can be protected from bombing and stuff like that. Scamman getting in here behind? Interesting. We do have both Ubers ready to go, so he and his scout are trying to force this Ubi. Does finish off Mush. In on the med! Ho-ho-ho! Uber is popped! Wow, iPony with those quick reflexes. Don't know if he would have survived that, but that Uber is popped. Red pops their Uber in retaliation. They have less than 2 minutes on the clock to take this, to hold this, and potentially take this round and potentially this match or map. not the match. There are two more maps to go. So, yeah, again with the Heavy from Power of Power. It's been going back and forth between Heavy and, oh, Mush taking out Saw right there. Leon trying to finish off Mush, but Mush is super hurt and super running away now. Scatman only one up for Red. They are going to get those respawns, which happened so fast. But yeah, so Coldplant, what I was trying to say is if your Heavy rolls out through this area, he is going to be protected, especially if he's wearing those Grue. He's going to be protected from jumpers. A little bit easier to roll out than, say, a Viaduct, I think. That is my opinion. Don't quote me on that. But, so Heavy, I guess that's the idea behind running this Heavy for several rounds now. Especially when they're not just defense. Okay, map will change after team wins four rounds. So we're going to go to four round wins. We are 2-2, don't forget. Right now, Blue, that is Mess Up, in possession of the point, just hanging on. So Leon is on the sniper. Did I get Leon and Power mixed up? I think I might have. Leon has been back and forth between sniper and such. But we do have the blue Uber popped trying to protect this point. Can Iratus connect right there? And no Scatman. There you go. Scatman gets finished off by Power, who's back up with that revved up minigun. So definitely trying to... Well, I thought maybe he was going to go protect his med, but he's just going to completely go out by himself and open himself up to death, which pretty much happened right there. So if you are going to play Heavy, you got to make sure on this King of the Hill that you're, you know, with the proper classes and doing your proper role, because that was just kind of a wasted life right there. But we'll see. Maybe he did that to come back as another class. No, it looks like he's still on that Heavy. Red did take the point right there, so we'll see if they can hold it. They have this 100% Uber, so they didn't even have to pop. That was nice. But Ipony had stayed alive, so he is holding on to that Uber as well. STV Stats tells us that Red lost their Uber advantage, but they're okay with that. If they can defend this point effectively. We do have that Heavy coming out from Leon. Some Uber versus Uber. Everyone is shiny and everyone is alive. Well, except for Leon, who goes down there. Mort's going down as well. Where did the medic escape? Oh, Pony did not escape. That was the thing. Sorry. But Saw did. I think Saw was the one I was looking for, actually. But regardless, so Saw is alive, does have, Rebrick? Rebrick does go down right there. I was going to say he does have all of his team up. Saw really wants that health. Okay, he got it. He got it, guys. It's okay. Oh, who's going to survive this? Oh, it is going to be Radis. Did he get it? I think he got an arrow to help him survive that fall, but does take down Scatman right there. Remember, Red has control of this point. Blue needs to get in there and mess up, definitely trying their darndest. Mort sending some rockets towards the point, and Demoman actually does have to get off the point to avoid them, so a nice strategy right there, but there's really nobody left alive for Red to stop this capture point. One scout, oh, in comes Scatman. He is respawned, and he is on a mission. The mission is to clear this point. It gives a nice air shot right there on Power. Oh, Scatman and Leon going down. Medic is left alive. Gets one Uber. Sorry, gets the Uber. What? Gets the 100% Uber with a Saw right there. And they'll be able to just hold on this point, wait for those respawns to come in. And Vintage looking awesome right there. So key play. Such plays. Such win for Vintage right there. Well played. Oh my goodness, and they still have to win one more to take this. God, it feels like this match is, it's so close, so it feels like, I don't know how these guys are going to be able to play all night. We'll play two more maps after this one. It's super intense. But no guts, no glory. There have been a lot of guts in this. See the battle for the roof right here. It looks like Red will take it. and push forward, getting some good time onto the point. That's pretty much what we've seen from Vintage, is these strong mid-fights that they are coming out and just being very aggressive. Whereas MessUp has usually tried to play a little bit cool, a little bit more conservative. Ipony does stay alive, whereas Saw, it looks like, did go down. So that's one of those instances of the pros and cons of one. If you play aggressive, sure, you get the point first, but you potentially open up your medic to harm. Whereas if you play a little bit more passive, wait for the other team to take, and then come back and retake, like we have MessUp doing right here, you lose time on the clock, but the theory is you'll be able to come back and take it easily. And they do take it back right there, and they do have this 100% Uber ready to go. Just looking at stats real quick, see if they don't show us anything or tell us interesting stories. I don't know. They're not speaking to me right now. Interesting that Leon is second on his team in points, and really the first frag class to be there. He's on sniper right now. So yeah, it's just interesting being able to consistently get those points and help his team out, despite the fact that he's been many classes in the past few seconds. Mush gonna try to take him out right here. Not able to do so as Rebrick takes him out with that pistol. We do have Uber exchanges and one... I believe that was Moritz who went for quite the air trip, courtesy of blue team MessUp right there. MessUp isn't done yet. They still have the heals. They still do heavy on the point, but Kachuk goes down in midair to a headshot. Look how aggressive Saw is being right here. He's got to watch out for this heavy who spun up and has got good tracking. Oh, it was heavy. It was a distraction. The heavy was a distraction because there was a soldier coming in from behind. Wow. Interesting. Who was that soldier? I gotta get Mush. That was Mush, of course. Mush, Mush. Mush, of course, being faster, I think. he does get discovered right there, and Scatman will finish him off. No, they kill each other. That's so cute. It was, yeah, that was cute. We do have Uber ready to go for blue. Are they going to pop it to save the point? Or are they just going to kind of hang out here, which looks like they are going to do? Obviously waiting for the right time, and this has got to be the right time. Need to stop the cap. There they go. Because they now have just about a minute left on the clock. Some nice bombs in here. We'll see if Saw can survive. He is not going to do it. So maybe there he goes. Finally gets finished off by Kachuk. Definitely lasted longer than I thought he would. But that's good news for him. Surviving, always good news for people who survive. And their friends, I guess. So we got 30 seconds left on the clock for MessUp. 2:30 for Vintage right here. So Vintage, after some crazy plays last round to hang on to the point, having a little bit of trouble getting the point this time. They do have player advantage right now, so they're stacking the point a little bit. Leon is doing a good job shutting down that opposing corner, as a threat of sniper will so often do. And yeah, they're going to be bombing in there a little bit as Aratus is trying to protect his medic, and he got the spun up heavy as well. So Pony will survive and actually has this 100% Uber. Are they going to pop in immediately? It looks like Pony can't. There we go. Just goes for that Oobs. Helps out his soldier. Nice flashing all around. Only 10 seconds left on the clock before it mess up. So if they get this and then just put an overhealed heavy on the point, it's going to be very difficult. But the red Uber is popped. Pony. Just run. Just run, dude. Just run. He will just run. He does escape alive, so he's gonna have a tiny Uber advantage, but Saw is gonna be right there with him. And that was a very nice comeback from the Vintage team to really stop that cap. We will see. A minute 30 left on the clock for Vintage. Scout coming in from behind. That is Power trying to cause some sort of chaos, but Saw was not having any of that. He was very well protected. Didn't take any damage from that. No drops. Pony, meanwhile, has this 100% Uber, so Red really should be bombing in there, trying to force that Uber if they're keeping track. Which, of course they are. Of course they're keeping track of Ubers. But we should have this push in coming. We saw that they had a little bit of an advantage and they lost that advantage. But red Uber is popped, so blue needs to hang back. Ah, they're just going to pop it and get right into blue red's face. Red going to try to get out of there as Scatman does go down. And some nice pills coming over, and WN is just going to get a 3k right there, which is some random spam. And here's a really nice hold from Vintage. They only have 30 seconds left. Remember, if they take this, they will win this round. A Scout who's just will not die, one of those. Aratinga gets in there, but he does finally go down. Rebrick, who got a scattergun kill on him. Only a little bit of time left on the point right there for Blue, as 16 seconds left for Vintage to hold on. They're not going to have an Uber or anything to pop, but they do have these heals. Gotta protect their med. Keeping the med alive and have those heals will enable his team to contest this point, and that's what they gotta do right now. Mush gets mowed down in midair. Power goes down on the board right there, and that is going to be another win. Round win for Team Vintage. So they do take that round. They do take this map. And spoiler alert, they do take the tournament, or the cup, so congratulations to them for winning the FBTF, or the Team Fortress Brazil Federation Cup. Anyway, thanks so much to Moritz who sent this in. I'm glad I was finally able to cast it for you. Congrats to both teams, really nice plays we saw from everyone. And shout out to the Brazil TF2 community, and keep being awesome, guys. Thanks so much for watching, have a good day.